Today's topic is cyber conjugation from general organic chemistry. This topic is more important students for your exam, and it is also very difficult for you to understand if you study from the textbook. So I will explain it very easily here. Here hyperconjugation will usually takes place. Alkenes and free radical. Carbocation is the one having carbon with a plus charge, plus sign. Alkene have double bond between two carbon atoms. Free radical have a carbon with a single electron. Now what is the condition for hyperconjugation to take place? To this carbocation, an sp3 hybridized carbon should be attached. This is the necessary condition for hyperconjugation. So this carbon is sp3 hybridized. If it is not there, hyperconjugation will not take place. So I am taking this compound. In this compound, this carbon is sp3 hybridized. Similarly, in alkenes, the double bonded carbon should be attached to an sp3 hybridized carbon. Here free radical, sp3 hybridized carbon is attached to the free radical carbon. Now let us explain how hyperconjugation takes place in carbocation. So let me take one example. CH3 single bond CH2 plus. In this compound, any one of the hydrogen may contribute for hyperconjugation. So this bond will be having two electrons. This electron will be shifted over here to form a double bond, so that the compound will be like this. This hydrogen is detached and we will get a double bond over here, and this will become CH2. Now some other hydrogen, any of these three hydrogen can contribute. This time this hydrogen is contributing the two electrons for the double bond, so the compound will be this hydrogen will be there, and here the hydrogen will be detached, forming a double bond over here. In another time, even this hydrogen can contribute. So this will be detached, forming a double bond like this. So totally I have three hyperconjugation structures. What decides the hyperconjugation structures, number of hyperconjugation structures, is that alpha hydrogen atoms. Alpha hydrogen atom is the one which is attached to alpha carbon. The carbon which is attached to carbocation is called as alpha carbon, and the hydrogens attached to alpha carbon are called as alpha hydrogen. So now let us explain how hyperconjugation takes place in alkene. So I will take an alkene, CH3 single bond CH double bond CH2. So as I told you already, any one of the hydrogen will be shifted. This is 1-propene. Now any one of the hydrogen will be contributing for hyperconjugation. Now the two electrons in this hydrogen is transferred to form a double bond, and this double bond will be transferred over CH2 to form a negative sign. Now this will be detached and the single bond become double bond, single bond CH2-. So this will takes place even like this, that is any of the other hydrogen may detached contributing for hyperconjugation. So this will be detached now. We will get a double bond over here, CH, single bond, CH2-. In another time, the third hydrogen can also, this hydrogen can also undergo hyperconjugation. So this will be detached, double bond CH, single bond CH2-. Let me explain now how hyperconjugation takes place in free radical. This is very important, students. Let me take an example, CH3, single bond CH2 dot. So now any one of the hydrogen, for example this hydrogen, will take part in hyperconjugation, transferring its electron. So in free radical, what will happen? The hydrogen will take its own electron, and one more electron will combine with the other electron in the CH2 group, forming a double bond. So this can be explained with any of the other hydrogen. So here also a similar structure will obtain. The hydrogen detached, taking its electron, and those two electrons forms a double bond. So now finally the third hydrogen also take part in hyperconjugation in the same fashion. So I have three hyperconjugation structures because I have three alpha hydrogen. Let us answer these questions based on hyperconjugation. These are very important, usually asked in exams. So let us see. We have three carbocations, and I want to find which compound is more stable. So what decides the stability of the compound? Here in this compound, I have how many alpha carbons? I have three alpha carbons, and to that alpha carbon, each alpha carbon, I have three hydrogens. So totally, how many alpha hydrogens I have? I have totally 9 alpha hydrogens. Here I have 3 alpha hydrogens. Here there is no alpha hydrogen because this hydrogen is attached to carbocation itself. So it is not the alpha hydrogen. So now what decides the stability? More the alpha hydrogen, more is the stability. So first compound is more stable than second compound. Second is more stable than third compound. Now let us do another example. See, in these three I want to find which is more stable. See, which is carbocation? The carbon with plus sign is called as carbocation. So this carbon is carbocation. So to that carbon, how many carbon is attached? 2 carbon is attached. So which means it is a secondary. Similarly, the second example, to that carbon, carbocation, I have only 1 carbon attached, so it is primary. In the last example, to that carbon, 3 carbon atoms are attached, so this is tertiary. So how many alpha hydrogens I will be having? In tertiary, I will be having more alpha hydrogens than secondary, than primary. So the order of stability will be like this. Tertiary will be more stable than secondary, that will be more stable than primary, which means that the third structure is more stable when compared to the first structure, which is more stable than the second structure. So this is our answer. Students, if you like this video, subscribe to my YouTube channel PK Academy for more these kind of videos. Thank you.